Schema markup is one of the most effective ways to make your site's content more discoverable. Essentially, it's a snippet of code that adds structure and meaning to your content, like labeling who wrote an article, what questions this page answers, or which comb Greamer swears by for his world-class beard. When answer engines like ChatGPT and Google's AI overviews look for information, they're not just reading your words, they're interpreting the context. Structured data helps your content stand out, builds trust in your brand, and strengthens your overall AEO and SEO strategy. So in this video, we're going to show how to add schema markup in Webflow, and we'll cover some things to keep in mind when doing this. First part, in Webflow, head over to Pages and open your page settings. Then scroll all the way down to Schema Markup. Here, you can add your own schema, or you can click Generate Schema Markup, and Webflow AI will automatically create it directly from your page's content. Once it's generated, take a moment to review it carefully and make any edits if needed. The goal here is to make sure the structured data matches exactly what's visible on the page. When everything looks good, go ahead and click Save. And remember, your schema markup doesn't go live until you publish your site. So once you're ready to go live with your schema markups, publish your site to make them visible to AI and search engines. Next, let's talk through a few best practices. First, you'll want to make sure you're using the right schema type. For example, blog posts use blog posting, product pages use product, and help pages often use FAQ or how-to. You can find the full list at schema.org, and Webflow supports all of them. Second, be accurate. Schema should always match what's visible on the page. Adding false or misleading information can hurt your authority. Third, update your schema when the content it references changes. For example, if you update a product description, publish date, or meta description that's included in your schema, make sure those details match. Keeping your structured data consistent with your page content helps both AI and search engines trust and display your information accurately. And finally, test your schema. You can do this either on schema.org or using Google's rich results test. Just copy your schema in Webflow, paste your code, then validate. If there are any errors, go ahead and fix those back in Webflow. And don't forget to save, then publish your changes. And that's it. That's how to add schema markup to your pages in Webflow.